It's a hot day, steamy hot, and it's happy hour. Three guys walk into a bar, and the first one says, "Hey guys, I'm gonna buy. Give me three beers, bartender." One of the guys says, "Well, wait a minute, it's hot outside. I'm really hot. I'll have two beers, so bartender, make that four." Bartender looks at the guys and says, "You boys work on the railroad, don't you?" And they looked at each other and they went, "Well, yeah. How'd you know?" And that's what we're going to talk about today. But first, welcome to another of our video tours from the Lake Spear Railroad Museum at the temporarily closed St. Louis County Depot here in downtown Duluth. Please help us out as best you can. Like our videos, that way you'll know they're coming. Also, share them with your family and friends so that they too can enjoy these daily tributes to railroad history. We're going to talk about joining trains together, or coupling the cars up to form a long train of cars. Two ways to do that. There's the knuckle coupler, that's this here, that's the modern version, we'll talk about that later. But the old school was what was called a link and a pin. The way that worked was, here's the coupler, there's one on each car. Your job as the brakeman is to insert the link and drop the pin. Now that's pretty easy when you think about it, but now there's another car coming your way. Your job now, grab another pin, hold the link up to align it with the other coupler, and as quickly as you can, drop the pin and get out of the way. Otherwise, you're going to end up like those guys in the bar. And this is what it looked like when they were coupled together. Here you have a link and two pins and two couplers showing what a train connection would look like. Now, the railroads liked this method because it was relatively inexpensive. Anybody could make these items. They were easily made, but not very strong, so they tend to break a lot. And then what was the other big disadvantage? Oh yes, that's right. They were horribly unsafe. Remember the guys in the bar. But keep in mind, this is long before OSHA, or workman's comp, or anything like that. Lives were expendable, and a hand? It meant nothing at all. So they were looking for a better idea. And there was no shortage of ideas, by the way. The railroads just didn't like them because they were expensive. At one point, they fought the whole idea, saying it would cost $30 million to convert all the train cars to a new form of coupler. That'd be about $400 million today. Well, as I said, everybody was looking for a solution. In 1875, there were 900 patents for different coupling systems. By 1887, oh man, there were 9,000 of them out there. But it was the one that Eli Janning thought of that caught on. And that was the knuckle coupler. Now, Eli Janney was a Confederate soldier. In fact, he was on the personal staff of Robert E. Lee, working with the general himself during the war. After the war, though, it wasn't so good for Eli. He was too broke to even go back to farming. So he became a dry goods clerk in Alexandria, Virginia. And there, he watched on his noon hour the goings-on at the Orange and Alexandria Railway. And he noticed how unsafe it was. In 1873, he came up with his first successful patent. He had had many, but they didn't work out. So the one that he successfully patented in 1873 was what we call the strongest handshake in the world. He came up with the idea of knuckles coming together, pins on the top and bottom. He came up with the knuckle coupler. Remember that handshake? All you had to do was, when the two cars came together and the pin dropped, there you had a tight couple and the cars were held together. His other big invention was this, a lever that wasn't between the cars, but at the side of the car, to pull the pin and release, or put the pin and be out of the way when the two came together to couple up. As good an idea as Eli had, it wasn't catching on with the railroads. Remember I said they were fighting the price of conversion. Well, they needed a champion, and they found it in Lorenzo Coffin. Lorenzo was working for a railroad and riding in a caboose one day when he witnessed one of those horrific accidents, and it appalled him to see it up close and very personal. And he was an evangelist by heart. He'd actually been a seminarian before joining the railroads. And what he did was he got the ear of President Harrison. And President Harrison in 1893 passed the Safety Appliance Act. The Railway Safety Appliance Act of 1893 gave railroads 7 years to convert from Lincoln pin couplers to the knuckle coupler. By the time they did, and in 1902, they had reduced accidents for coupling from 40% of all the accidents on the railroad with the Lincoln pin to just 4% using the knuckle coupler. That was a major advance. Today's major advance is wash your hands, cover your coughs, don't touch your face, keep that social distance, and as always, let's take care of each other.